Hello, this is Mike here with your Mike Minute. Today we're going to be talking about electronic signatures and how we manage that with Content Central. The first thing we'll need to do is we'll need to get a new document into Content Central. We'll start by opening up a Microsoft Word document, in this case a contract. Of course, you may be working on this contract, changing content, and you'd want to do that in a productivity software like Microsoft Office or Word in this example. Then when I'm ready, I'm going to simply use the Content Central integration tab here to capture this document into Content Central. Now I can make a selection as to what kind of document this is. Today we're going to focus on a contract, and we'll just put in a few index values here. And then simply click upload to add this document to the system. Now we're going to minimize Word for a moment. We're going to log directly into Content Central because we want to send this document for that signature. So we'll just put in our username and password. And waiting right there on the dashboard in our work queue is that contract. You can see the file's been named, is ready to be sent for signature. We can see that index information over on the right-hand side. Again, we got a three-page document. I'm going to open up my action drawer over here on the right-hand side, and I'm going to choose signatures. Now, I have several options here, and what I want to focus on today is called document type. Now, we've already created a signature template requiring the signature blocks. If you want to learn more about that, we'll do a follow-up video on that. I'm just simply going to put in the email address of who I want to send this document to be signed by, and then simply click send to send that document for signature. Now, while the document is sent out, I can review the status of documents, that have been sent out for signature, things of that nature, as well as let's take a look at what's involved in signing that document of that user. We'll just simply come over to the email notification that was sent out. This is the basic simple email message template, but they are adjustable, configurable and customizable. We're just going to click that link to go ahead and provide the signature. See, it autofills the date. It could do the same for things like your printed name, even requiring them to enter a title. Kept it simple for this one. We're going to click submit. More email notifications can fire back to the person that requested the signature. Again, just giving them a link to review that document. And if we log back in and review that document inside that work queue, we can simply scroll down and see that that signature is now applied. Thanks so much for joining us with this Mike Minute today. There will be plenty of new videos following about the new signature feature and the advanced workflow capabilities that it offers.
Make sure to check out some of my other Mike Minutes or click the links below for more document management resources.